Greetings, fellow warriors, and welcome back to a special Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord video series, where I, Artem, take a deep dive into some of the new released and upcoming total conversion mods for the game. If you haven't seen the Burning Empires one yet, you should totally check it out, since I'm spending a lot of time creating these, and a like on this video and a subscription to the channel would be much appreciated, so thank you. As for today, we're taking a look at the Trial of the Seven Kingdoms Game of Thrones modification that you can even play right now and look at what's already there and what's to come, since it's in a huge work in progress phase. So sit back and enjoy while I tell you all about the Trial of the Seven Kingdoms modification for Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Trial of the Seven Kingdoms is a total conversion mod set in the A Song of Ice and Fire universe for Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord, and its story takes place right after Robert's Rebellion, 30 days before Jon Arryn's death. Events will then pop up every 15 to 30 days, like Robert and Ned's death, etc. Its main features are a ginormous new campaign map that will include everything from Westeros, Essos, and even the Dothraki Sea. Custom settlements like King's Landing, Winterfell or Casterly Rock, with its own scenes and 3D models on the world map, as well as all new kingdoms and cultures fitting for the Game of Thrones universe, such as the Westerlands, known for its rugged hills, rolling plains, fertile fields and broadleaf forests, ruled by the House Lannister. Or the Riverlands, encompassing a region of plains, forests, hills and endless rivers, bordering almost every single kingdom except Dorne, and is being ruled by House Tully. The other kingdoms, for example, are Dorne, which is the hottest region of Westeros, with its rocky, mountainous, arid and dry climate, containing the only desert on the continent, and it's ruled from its capital Sunspear by the Martells. The north is sparsely populated, with vast wilderness, forests, pine-covered hills and snow-capped mountains, speckled with tiny villages at holdfasts, ruled from Winterfell by House Stark. The Stormlands, which is one of the smaller regions of Westeros, is a land of harsh mountains, stony shores and verdant forests, ruled by the House Baratheon. The Vale is a land of fertile soil, rivers and lakes, which is being ruled by the Arryns. The Reach, being considered the most fertile and heavily populated part of Westeros, is ruled from Highgarden by the House Tyrell. And the Free Cities, all the way back in Essos. During your journeys you will encounter a lot of important notables from the books and TV series, such as Robert Baratheon, the King of Andals and Protector of the Realm, wielding a mighty warhammer which he used to end the Targaryen rule in Westeros. Other notable characters include Robb Stark, Joffrey Baratheon, Jon Snow and many more. I could name them all, but then the video would be 30 minutes long, since there are so many and no one wants to listen to this, so here's a quick list of every new important character added to the game. Of course, the companions you may encounter are also noteworthy people from this universe. Regarding quests, the team is going to implement a bunch of new side quests and a main storyline, following the main story of the show and the books. Something that is unique to this mod is the integration of Blox Freelancer mod and Swadin Armory by a damn sexy name. The Freelancer mod gives you the ability to enlist in a party as a mere soldier, fighting for your liege and climbing up the ranks until you become one of the personal guards. Some of the other features that this mod has to offer are all new custom weapons and armor. Valyrian steel weapons. Important weapons like Oathkeeper, Blackfyre or Longclaw. Naval travel and combat, which I'm very excited for. Port to port travel. Random world events such as Eddard Stark's death, triggered war and marriages and much more. Regarding dragons, the team found a way to implement them into the game already, without the need to create custom animations. You can see them randomly flying around in the world. But if you wanna go eye to eye with some of the beasts, you should check out the throne room in King's Landing, where you can see one up close. In the future, they plan to make these dragons rideable and even dangerous by adding a devastating fire breath to their attack pattern. But it's a long way to go for this kind of thing, since the game is still in early access, but I can't wait to see how this will play out. White Walkers will also be a thing. After some time and some events being played out by the main story, there will be a point where White Walkers will slowly creep out of the graves to invade all of Westeros, leaving no one alive as long as the Night King hasn't been defeated. Like I already said, the mod is in a heavy work in progress phase, so a lot of the features I talked about today may not be included right now or will ever be included in general, and the plans may change. One of the big aspirations from the lead coder is to build separate game modes we can load into to play in different time periods with a different story, which I'm very excited for. We all know how the series ended, let's just forget the last season. So it's nice to see them adding their own touch to the mod and create something new and fresh. The future is definitely bright, and I am amazed by how much work the team has already done to create something that is already stable and playable. What would you like to see in the mod in general, even if it's not planned? Tell me down in the comment section below, I am very curious to see what you guys want. For me personally, I would love to play as the White Walkers, just a giant horde of zombies killing everything in their path until everyone is dead. Well, this sounds better on paper than actually saying it out loud. I am not a psychopath though. As for a release date, well, it's already released, in its earliest form though. So there's a lot of content to be added and bugs to be ironed out, to make you actually feel like you're not just playing a mod, but a whole new game set in the Game of Thrones universe. I've played it quite a bit, and it was a lot of fun revisiting Westeros in all its glory again, and I can't wait to see what they do with this mod in the future. And yeah, I guess that is it for this video. As always, all the links regarding this mod will be in the description down below, as well as their Discord server, Nexus mod page and website. If you liked this video, please hit that subscribe button. It would help out the channel tremendously and show me that you want to see more content like this in the future. Join my Discord server, where you can talk with me and other like-minded people, and I'll see you all in the next one. Stay safe, warriors, and bye.